हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी डिस्कस अबाउट सम एग्जांपल्स, राइट? ओके, आवर फर्स्ट एग्जांपल इज एग्जांपल नंबर 3. अ टैंक इज फिल्ड विथ अ वाटर टू अ हाइट ऑफ 12.5 सेंटीमीटर. द एपरेंट डेप्थ ऑफ अ नीडल लाइंग एट द बॉटम ऑफ द टैंक इज मेजर बाय अ माइक्रोस्कोप to be 9.4 centimeter. What is the refractive index of water? So we have to find out refractive index of water. Okay. If water is replaced by a liquid of refractive index 1.63 up to the same height, by what distance would be moved to focus on the needle again, right? Now friends, here we discuss about first case, right? So here tank is full with water to height of 12.5 centimeter. So here suppose this is tank, okay? Yeah, this is tank, right? This tank is filled with a water, right? So here water, here the height is 12.5, which is real depth, right? So here we denoted this by h2 is equals to 12.5 centimeter, right? Okay. The apparent depth of needle lying at the bottom of tank is measured by a microscope to be 9.4 centimeter, right? So here something like this is 9.4, so here we call h1, right? Okay, so this is our apparent depth, which is 9.4. So we can write that h1 is equals to 9.4 centimeter, h2 is equals to 12.5 centimeter, right? Now the bottom of the tank is measured by a microscope to be 9.4 centimeter. What is the refractive index of water? So your water is our second medium, right? Because microscope is like here in air. So here this is our first medium N1 and this is our second medium N2, right? So value of N1, we know refractive index of air 1, N2 we have to find out, right? Okay, so friends, we know the formula of refractive index with the height. We already studied that refractive index of rarer medium upon refractive index of denser medium is equals to apparent height upon real height. So here refractive index of rarer medium, which is N1, upon refractive index of denser medium, which is N2, is equals to apparent height, h1, upon real height h2, right? Now we have to put these values. N1 1 upon N2 is equals to h1 9.4 upon h2 12.5. so here we have to formulate N2. So N2 is equals to, by cross product, 12.5 upon 9.4, right? N2, as we formulate N2, 12.5 upon 9.4 is equals to 1.33. So N2 is equals to 1.33. So we can write that refractive index of water is equals to 1.33. Right. Now friends, we discuss about second case. If Water is replaced by a liquid of refractive index 1.63, right? So here instead of water, there will be some liquid having refractive index 1.63, right? So by what the distance would be moved to focus on the needle again? So we have to find out the distance by which microscope is displaced, right? We can say that. But here, if we have to find out displacement, first of all, we have to find out the apparent height, right? So when water is replaced by a liquid, then H1 we have to find out, H2 real height 12.5 centimeter, N1 1, and N2 refractive index of liquid we know that 1.63, right? So we can write that H1 we have to find out, H2 12.5, N1 1, N2 refractive index of liquid 1.63. We already know the formula, N1 upon N2 is equals to H1 upon H2. We have to formulate H1, but before we have to put all the values, N1 1 upon N2 1.63, H1 we have to find out, upon H2 12.5. See here, as we formulate H1, we can say that H1 is equals to 12.5. goes to left hand side, so H1 is equals to 12.5 divided by 1.63, right? So we can write that. So H1 is equals to 12.5 upon 1.63, which is equals to 7.66, or we can say that 7.7 centimeter, right? So we can say that apparent depth in liquid, which is equals to 7.7 centimeter, right? So here we have to find out, see here friends, by what the distance would be moved to focus on the needle again. So in first case, when there is a water, the apparent height is 9.4, and when water is replaced by a liquid, then we get apparent depth is 7.7 centimeter, right? So friends, we have to find out the distance by which microscope is dispatched, right? Or we can say that distance would be moved to focus, right? Because we have to focus through the microscope, na, right? So here, when water depth is 9.4 and for liquid 7.7, so in first case the height is 9.4 and in second case 7.7, so we have to subtract 7.7 from the 9.4, right? So we can write that distance by which microscope is displaced is 9.4 minus 7.7. so we can say that 9.4 minus 7.7, which is 1.7 centimeter, right? Okay, you understand this example? Okay, now our next example, example number 4. Figure A and B So, refraction of a ray in air incident at 60 degree. You can see in this figure 60 degree. With the normal to a glass air. You can see that normal to a glass air. And water air interface respectively. Right here in water air. Predict the angle of refraction in glass. Here in figure C, glass. When the angle of incident in water is 45, you can see here angle of incidence 45. With the normal to a water glass interface. So friends, here three figures are given. In first, there is air glass interface. In second, water air interface. And in third, water glass interface. Here see in this figure A. So air glass interface angle of incidence is 60 degree and angle of refraction is 35 degree. Next, in figure B, there is air water interface. Here angle of incident is 60 degree and angle of refraction is 47 degree. And in third figure, there is a glass water interface. Angle of incidence is 45 degree and we have to find out the angle of refraction for glass. Right. So here, see in this figure C, there are two mediums, water and glass. Our first medium is water because here a ray incident in water medium, right? So water is our first medium and glass is our second medium. Here theta 1 is given. We have to find out the angle theta 2 in glass medium. So here there are two mediums and two angles. So simple, here we easily apply the Snell's law. We know that the equation of Snell's, n sine theta is equals to constant, so we can write that n1 sin theta 1 is equals to n2 sin theta 2. But we know the value of theta 1, we have to find out theta 2. N1 is n water, right? Because water is our first medium, and n2 our second medium, n glass. But we don't know the refractive index of water and glass. So friends, first of all, we have to find out the refractive index of water and glass. To find out the refractive index of water and glass, we have to take help of our figure A and figure B. See here figure A, air glass medium. Here theta 1, theta 2 known, N1 which is medium of air. We know N medium of air, the refractive index of air is 1. So we can easily find out the refractive index of glass. So we can easily find out the refractive index of glass. Now see in this second figure, there are two mediums, air and water. Theta 1 is known 60, theta 2 is known 47. First medium is air, second medium is water. So we can easily find out the refractive index of water. Okay, so first of all, we have to discuss about figure A, right? So we can write that like this. Okay, right. Okay, so from figure A, so we apply Snell's law. So n1 is n A, we can say that NA, refractive index of air. Sine theta 1 is 60 degree, is equals to N2 which is the medium of glass. So we can write NG. Sine theta 2 which is 35 degree. We know refractive index of air 1, right? So we don't want to write it. Okay, N F one. So sine 60 is equals to N G sine 35. So we have to find out the N G refractive index of glass. So N G is equals to sine 60 degree divided by sine 35 degree. Right. So from the natural sine, your logbook. Right. So with the help of your logbook, you can easily find out the value of sine 60 and sine 35. So from logbook, the value of sine 60 is 0.8660 divided by value of sine 35, 0.5736. So as we divide this, we can get 1.51. Right. So the refractive index of glass is 1.51. Okay. Now we have to find out the refractive index of water. So here, see the figure 2. Okay. So from figure B. So from figure B. Where is incident ray? In first medium of air. And after that, it is going to the medium of water. So here, N1 is medium of air. So we can write Na sine theta 1 is 60 is equals to N2, which is N water, Nw sine theta 2, 45. Na1, right? See here, friends. From figure B, Na sine 60 is equals to Nw sine 45. So Na is 1. So sine 60 degree is equals to Nw sine 45. So Nw is equals to sine 60 divided by sine 45. Again, from the natural sine, we can find out sine 60. 0.8660 upon sine 45. 0.73. Sorry, friends, here the angle is 47. See, 47. Okay, so here instead of 45, 47 degree. Right, 47 degree. Right, so here value of sine 47 degree, which is 0.7314. Right. So 0.8660 divided by 0.7314, which is 1.184. Right. So refractive index of water, Nw is equals to 1.184. Now we know the value of refractive index of glass and water. So now from figure C, right? So from figure C, see this figure. See here incident ray in water. So our first medium is water and second medium is glass. So we can write that N1, so Nw sine theta 1 is 45 degree is equals to N2 Ng sine, we have to find out the angle theta 2 or theta, whatever you want to write, right? So friends, we know the value of Nw and Ng, right? So here we formulate sine theta 2. So sine theta 2 is equals to Nw upon Ng into sine 45. So here we know the value of Nw, which is 1.184 divided by Ng 1.51. Sine 45, we know the value of sine 45 from the natural sine. So sine 45 is 0.7071. So by the product and After the dividation, we get sine theta 2 is equals to 1.184 into 0.7071 divided by 1.51. So we can get 0.5544. So 0.5544 or 5545. So here sine theta 2 is 0.5544. We have to find out theta 2. So here we have to take the sine inverse, right? So here we have to take theta 2 is equals to sine inverse 0.5544. So with the help of natural sine, after taking inverse, we can write that theta 2 is equals to 33.7 degree or around 34 degree, right? Okay, you understand, friends? Okay. Now, see here, our next example, illustration number 5. The earth takes 24 hours to rotate one about its axis. How much time does the sun take to shift by 1 degree when viewed from the earth? Right. So here this is a simple example. Right. Okay. Now here we know that angular displacement by earth in one rotation takes 360 degree, right? We can easily see in this figure, this is earth, initial condition 0 degree, this is 90, 180, 270 and 360, right? So here, when earth completes its first rotation, angular displacement is 360 degree, right? So here, time taken for a shift of 360 degree. Here, time taken for a shift 360 degree is 24 hours. So time for 1 degree is equals to how much? So this is a basic maths, right? So we can write that angular displacement by earth in one rotation around itself is 360 degree, right? So we can easily can say that time taken for shift of 360 degree is equals to 24 hour. Then time for shift of 1 degree is equals to how much, right? So time is equals to 1 degree into 24. So 1 into 24 divided by 360. So we can say that, oh, so time 1 into 24 by 360. So 1 into 24 by 360. So that time is equals to 24 upon 360 hours. If we want to convert in minute, so we already know that 1 hour is equals to 60 minute, right? So we have to multiply by 60. So time is equals to 24 into 60 divided by 360. So here 6, 4. So time is 4 minute. Right. So we can write that. Time for shift 1 degree is equals to 4 minute. Okay. You can easily understand this. And if we have to write this answer in second, so here we have to convert minute to second, which is 60. So we can also say that 4 into 60, so 240 seconds, right? Okay, you can understand this easily, right? Okay, thank you.